Yesterday we discussed about your PAN. So what is the long form of PAN? Yes, that is personal area network. So you understood about what is the meaning of computer network? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
You understood which all are the components of computer networks? Yes or no? Okay. Next, in today's class, we'll discuss that is your next type of computer networks, local area network. So you all can see this screen.
Yes, ma'am.
What is there in your screen? Yes, what you can see?
Networking concepts.
What you can see on the screen?
Chapter
networking
concepts.
Networking concept.
You can't see this local area network is not visible to you on the screen?
No, ma'am. We can only see the.
Then what is visible? What is visible?
Chapter 1 networking concept.
Okay. Now what you can see in the on the screen? Okay. Okay. So, okay, stop it now. In yesterday's class, we discussed personal area network. Okay. So, in personal area network, the range it is having smaller range from 5 to 10 meters. In PAN, okay. So, in PAN, you are using the mobile phone. Sometimes you are connecting your hotspot to your friends. That time, if you are nearer to that place, then you can able to connect to that Wi-Fi. But if you are far from that place, then you can't able to connect to the Wi-Fi. As I gave you the example in the previous class. So you understood what is the meaning of personal area network? Okay, so next in the today's class, we will see the next part of your network component, that is local area network. Okay. So you all can see this local area network. The screen is visible to you all. Okay. So now see here, as you can see this at the middle, one switch is there. And these are some of the devices which is connected to this main switch. Okay. So as you saw your computer lab in your school.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in that, one main switch is there for internet connection, and there are some of the computers which are connected to only that one switch. Okay. And it is located in that computer. It is located in your school, in your computer lab. So this local area network, it is connected only through the particular area. That means what? If you suppose if you open a new office, okay, and if you brought some of the 40 computers, and if you connected that through one of the internet connection, okay, so then the network through that particular area in your building, in your office, there are having 40 computers. In that you are connecting the only one switch, and that switch is going to give the network for all that 40 computers. So the network which is connected only through only that one particular building, that is nothing but your local area network. As you can see this, when two or more computers are connected within a small range like a room, office building or a campus. Example is nothing but, as you can see your school, in your school computer lab is there. So all computers, it is connected only one switch. That is the best example. As you can see here also, there is one switch, and this switch is connected to this all other computers over here, and it is having the range only till 10 kilometer. If we'll go more than that, then the range will not come. So it is having only the range till 10 kilometers, and it can be used for the locally. Next, a LAN have minimum 2 or maximum 1000 computers. It means what? You can use minimum 2 computers and maximum 1000 computers you can connect to that main switch. you can't connect more computers to that switch. So if you want to connect that local area network, then you can connect the maximum 1,000 computers, not more than that. So you understood what is the meaning of local area network now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So next we will see the next part of computer network is campus area network. As you saw your school campus, okay? In your school is there. In that, computer lab is there. In computer lab, the internet connection is connected. So from that internet connection, suppose if I want to use from that internet connection, I want to use the same connection in the school library. After school library, if I want to connect that same internet connection in the college level, that is for PU. After that, if I want to use the same connection for SBG, that is medical college which you saw. Then same connection if I want to use again for the, that is your PU college, then for your SBG. If I want to use same for your B.Ed. college, then we through that whole campus, we can use the same internet connection which is having in the computer lab. So that is nothing but your campus area network. It is not like that only we have to use in the school building. That is, suppose if your building is there, okay, if your home is there, and the neighborhood homes also, if they want to use your same internet connection, they can use the same internet connection which is having in your home. So that is nothing but your campus area network. Who is making noise? Yes? So what do you mean by campus area network now? Yes? What I explained just now? Can anyone tell?
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
Can anyone tell what do you mean by this campus area network?
Ma'am, the network is connected to the multiple local areas.
Yes, and it is having the larger range as compared to the LAN and WAN. LAN, it is having, compared to LAN, it is having the larger range. And in campus area network, whole campus we can connect through only one switch. As you can see in the picture, there is one switch, and through that switch, it is connected to four buildings. You can see in the picture, yes? This main switch, it is connected to four buildings. So we can use the same switch and connections, we can use this all four buildings, neighborhood places we can use, that is campus area network. So you all understood what is the meaning of this campus area network?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
What is the range of campus area network?
Campus area network, it is having the maximum range than LAN. So LAN is having, it is range of till 10 kilometers. So it is having the range till 20 kilometer. Okay? It is less than 50. It is having the range less than 50 kilometers, not more than that. Understood? Understood everyone? Okay. So next we will see MAN. What is the long form of MAN?
Metropolitan Area Network.
Yes, it is Metropolitan Area Network. As you can see in the picture, so there is one main switch, that is MAN, and this MAN is the connection of too many LANs. So as you know, what is the meaning of LAN? We can connect in LAN. It is used for only particular building, that is for only one building we can use, and we can connect that LAN maximum 1,000 computers we can connect. But what is the meaning of this MAN here now? This MAN, it is connected to too many LANs. So as I told you, your computer lab, that is nothing but your LAN. So here it is connected like that computer lab. There are connected so many LANs over here. So the man, as compared to land, it is having the maximum range, and it ranges from 10 kilometer to 15 kilometers. As you can see in the man, it's having the maximum range. So you can use, suppose I'll give you an example for you. I'll give you your example of school. Okay. So you can use the computer lab, that is main switch, that you can use, suppose if there is having the MAN area network. Okay, there is having the network connection, network type is MAN. Then that same connection you can use in the neighborhood buildings, which is outside of your school buildings are there. You can use that same connection of MAN, you can use in the outside buildings of your school. That is nothing but your MAN connection. So you understood what is the meaning of this MAN? So here they gave an example. Okay. So here they gave an example, that is cable TV network. As you know, your cable is connecting to.
Yes.
Okay. Suppose your TV network, it is connected to your home. Okay. That cable is connected to your home, and your neighborhood TVs also connection is having in your home only. Okay. So that same cable, it is connected to the neighborhood home also. So that is the one of the example of your metropolitan area network. It means what? It is having the maximum range, and it is a combinations of your lands, and it is having the range from 10 kilometers to 50 kilometers, and it is having the wide range. So you understood about the MAN?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next is what? What you can see in the picture? What you all can see? Yes, that is? Okay. Next is your WAN, that is wide area network. So what is the meaning of this wide area network now? In your computer networks, it is wide geographical area. It is nothing but this wide area network. It is having the largest area. It will cover the largest area over here. It forms by connecting the LANs and MANs. As you know, LAN is nothing but only through the particular building we are using. As we discussed, MAN is nothing but it is used for the, it is combinations of that LAN also and CAN also. It means what? It is having the maximum range. But in wide area network, it is a combination of that both. It forms both LAN as well as MAN. So as you can see this, this is here your WAN, and it is connected to LAN also and MAN also. So it is having the maximum range over here. Okay. So if you want to do the examples, is here railway reservation system and ATMs. So you can use this, you can do the railway reservation system from anywhere, and you can use the ATMs over there with any places. And this whatever WAN is there, it is sharing the data with the help of fiber optic cables and microwaves. If you want to share the data, then you can share the data. For that, you are going to use in this, they will be use the cables, that is fiber optic cables and microwaves cable. Okay. So this, as compared to all the networks, this wide area network, it is having the maximum range. So the name itself, it given as what? Wide area network. So these all are the five types of your computer network. That is, four types. That is LAN, MAN, WAN and CAN. So you all understood about this, or any doubt in these types of computer networks?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so you understood about the LAN?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so for what purpose LAN is used? At least tell me where it is used.
No, no.
Yes, it is used for the local areas. Okay, it is particular to that building, or suppose a particular to that office only it is used, because it is having the less range. It is having the only range still 10 kilometers. It is not having maximum than that. Next comes MAN. It is nothing but it is metropolitan area network. What is the meaning of this metropolitan area network? As compared to the LAN and pan, it is having the maximum range, and it ranges till 20 kilometers minimum to 50 kilometers. Next is your WAN, that is wide area network. This wide area network, as compared to this all networks, it is having the maximum range over there. So the name itself is given as wide area network, and it forms the connections from LANs and MANs. Next comes campus area network. It is one switch is there, and that switch is connected to whole your campus. That is, it might be used for your computer lab, it might be used for your colleges, it might be used for your library, it might be used for offices, like that. This is your whole campus, it is used, that is called as your campus area network. So you all understood the different types of your computer networks?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So next we'll see network topology. What is the meaning of topology? What is the meaning of topology? Can anyone tell? Okay. So I'll tell you, students. Topology is nothing but it is the layout. Okay. And it is computers are connected to one another for a network. So as you can see in the lab, these all computers are connected to one another, and connection is have a switch is there. There is a only one switch. Through that switch, the all computers are connected to one another. So that is nothing but your topology. So as you know, in the previous class, we discussed what is the definition of network. What is the definition of network now here? I'll tell you here. Network, it is the communication between the two or more computers, or it is communication between two or more things. That is nothing but your network. So as you know, network definition, it is the communication between two or more things, or it is the communication between two or more computers. So here comes topology now. Topology is nothing but it is the layout, how a network communicates with different devices. It is the layout in how network communicate with different devices. In the sense, what? Suppose one computer wants to communicate with another computer, then how it is connecting with the help of network, that is called as topology. If one computer wants to communicate with another computer with the help of network, that is called your network topology. So you all understood what is the meaning of network topology? Yes?
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next we will see types of computer network topology. So there are mainly four types of network topology. There is bus topology, ring topology, star topology, and mesh topology. So these all network topology we are going to use to communicate between one computer to another computer with the help of the network. So these all four types we will see one by one. So as you can see in the picture, what you can see in the picture now?
Bus topology.
Can you tell me how this structure is looking like?
Chart.
It's looking like chart. Okay, so now see here. Yes, this bus topology, the structure is exactly looking like a bus. So the name is given as what? Bus topology. So as I gave you one example, if you want to go from Belgaum to Bangalore, okay, then you're going with the help of bus, and some people, they're getting down in another places, and you're getting down finally at the Bangalore. Okay. So now see here, in bus topology, this is called as your one of the cable. This is your cable, and this cable is connected these computers are connected to these cables. So whatever this device is there, whatever this computer is there, this is called as node. This is your cable, and for this cable, these devices are connected. So these devices are here, nodes over here. Okay, so these different nodes are connected to this only one cable. And this is your start terminator and this is your end terminator. Okay, suppose now this is the, okay, so as you can see this sender and here it is receiver. Suppose, assume that this sender wants to send the message to this computer. This device wants to send the message to this computer. Then this sender, it will send the message as hi. This hi message, it will go till here, but this tab will not open. Again, it will go here. This tab will not open. So finally, it will go here. This tab will open and this message, it directly go over here and receiver will take this message hi. Suppose hi message he will take and he wants to send him message again hello. Okay. He wants to send the message hello to this device. So how it can send? It will send the message hello. So it will come till here. This tab will not get open. Again it will come here. This tab will not get open. Again it will come here and this tab will get open and this message directly it will reach till here. So that is nothing but how this bus topology send the message. So in bus topology, there is only one cable is used and all the devices that is called nodes. These nodes are connected to this only particular cable. This is your start terminator. This is your end terminator. This device can send the message or this device can communicate to this computer. But whenever this device communicate to this computer, other staff will not get open. This other can't see the message, what message this device is sending. It directly goes and this staff only will get open and it will send the message to this device. So this device, if you want to send the message again to this, then it will send the message and it will go like this. These staffs will not be get open over here. So you understood in bus topology how the communication is happens. Okay. So in the next slide, we can see there are having some of the advantages and disadvantages of this bus topology. Now first we'll see the some of the advantages over here. As you know, in bus topology, we are using only one cable. As you can see this middle cable, we are using only one cable. Okay. So because of that, we are using only one cable, that is only one wire, so it is less expensive. So first advantage of this is what? It is only one wire, so because of that, less expensive. Next, it is situated for temporary network. Because of it is having the small range, it is situated for the temporary network. It is not situated for the permanent network. It is situated only for the particular, that is temporary. Temporarily it is connected. Next you can see nodes failures does not affect others. As I told you in the previous slide, suppose if this device is sending the message to this device and if this device is failure, this is not working. Okay, so whenever this device is sending the message to this device and if this device is failure, then nothing will happen. Okay, so this device can directly send the message to this. So that is the third advantage it is having. That is nothing but what? If the node's failures does not affect others. Means what? This node, it wants to send the message to this node. And if this node or this node will get failure, then it will not affect to others. So these are the three advantages of your bus topology. That is, it is using only one wire. Bus topology is using only one wire. That is, so it is less expensive. It is situated for temporary network. It is not for permanent. It is situated for temporary. So this is the one more advantage. And if this node wants to send the message to this node, then if this or this node failure, then it will not affect to this. Understood this? Advantages of bus topology?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in this? Any doubt you have? Yes?
Can you once more define topology?
Okay. You want to know topology. Okay. So as you can see, before that we discussed network. So what is the definition of network? It is the communication between two or more things. It is the communication between the one computer to another computer. So now it came here, topology. Topology is nothing but it is layout of how network communicate with different devices. As you know, network is nothing but one computer is communicating to another computer. But topology is nothing but what? How that communication is happening from one computer to another computer with the help of network. That is called your topology. How the communication is happening from one computer to another computer. Understood now? Understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Again, any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you understood which all are the advantages of bus topology?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is the meaning of this? Only one wire, less expensive. First advantage.
Ma'am, first wire. Ma'am, it is connected.
Yes.
Ma'am, it is only one wire, it is connected to the
low
computer.
It is using only one wire for the connections of all the devices, so it is less expensive. As you can see in the picture, it is using only one wire for all the connections of devices, so it is less expensive. It is situated for temporary network. It is not, we can't use permanent because it is having minimum range. Next, node failures does not affect others. Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of this? Node failures does not affect others. As I told you.
Ma'am, if a message is going to other computer,
yes,
and it fails, then it won't affect the other computer.
Yes. If this computer wants to send the message to this last one computer, and if in between the middle, these two computers, if it is fails, if it is not working, then it will not affect to these computers while sending the message to this computer. So you understood the advantages?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so at 11:45 again we have class. So in that class we'll see the next part of this chapter.